This is the first slab off the underside of the log. And this face right here was really close to the bark. I took a real light cut to get down to the first slab to reduce the amount of waste out of these logs. And this side's okay, but the other side should be a lot better, and I'm not sure how it's gonna look. I thought I would know how this log was gonna look as we sawed it today, but I've been completely wrong so far, except for the one crotch area. So, let's just scrape it off and see how it looks. Not too bad. You can see the grain swirling out toward this crotch area. I would say the next slab, we cut two slabs, so we'll pull it off next. I forgot. The slab right below this one should have the crotch figure showing up all in this area right here. Still a good slab. No crotch figure, but we're okay. Something else I want to point out is we're yet to saw where the check was that we pointed out of the first of the video. So that's why you're seeing all these slabs with nice solid ends on them. The next, I think the next slab should start getting into that check, and we'll find out how deep it runs. So, really happy with these though. There's no checking at all in them. Good stuff. We'll throw some water on this one also. There's a lot of nice cathedrals going on in here where the end grain comes up on the face of the wood. And we got a knot on the bottom down here, no big deal. But this is some nice figure in here. This ain't bad at all. Oh yeah, some nice cherry in there. This looks really nice right here. These cathedrals are really showing up here on the middle. It looks like flat sawn material. And it looks really good. Another tip here on drying, when you're laying out your stickers between your slabs, these are stickers, and a lot of people saw their own stickers up. I use pine 1x2s from Lowe's, which is I think a half inch by inch and a half or something like that. They come in 8-foot sections. I cut them down to 4 feet. But more importantly is you can use anything for stickers as long as it's dry. And like I said, this is just a fast thing to use. You can buy these for a little bit of nothing at Lowe's. And after a while, you accumulate a lot of them. But something real important here on stacking, you want to space your stickers 16 inches apart, just like you do studs on a wall. Very important. Always space them at least 16 inches. Now these next two or three slabs, probably the last three, probably get three more out of this cherry here, but all three of these slabs are going to contain that check that we talked about at the first of the video. So hopefully this check won't run too deep. Up here on the face, it looks like it's running in about 2 inches, then it goes away. So hopefully as we get down in here further, the check will not be a big issue here. And these are 9-foot slabs, so if they just go in, if this just goes in less than 6 inches or more, we're okay. Now if this check goes in a foot or more, then that's not a good thing. We're gonna have to do some cutting after we dry it to get that check out of there. But we'll see what happens. Hopefully this check will not be as bad as it looks. So right here is the check running this direction. Let's see if it's on the face of this slab. And we're in good shape. The check really doesn't go in at all on this one. It goes in just a little bit here on the top, then it's gone. So that's pretty good. I was worried about that check going deep into this timber, but I think we're gonna be okay. We'll be right back.